Tutorial Chapter 2. Bumper Bed Limited sells various styles or sizes of beds. The year-end inventory valuation is in progress and some analysis of inventory is required. The year-end is the 31st of March 2006. Matt Bush, the accountant, has asked you to assist in the year-end valuation process. The inventory count has been performed at two finished goods warehouses. You've been asked to save the spreadsheet in the appropriate location and rename it as MATST, Chapter 2, Spreadsheet Skills, Case Study, Bumper Beds Limited Answer. So I'm going to go File, Save As, and call it what it's asking me to call it. Now I like to do the exercises on the left and the tasks on the right. So View, New, View, Arrange All, Vertical. Here I can have the summary, which is the spreadsheet, and on the left I can have the exercises so I can read what I'm being asked to do. It says complete the following in the summary worksheet. In column D, use a formula to link the appropriate items in finished goods warehouse 1 and finished goods warehouse 2 to find the total number of items held. So this is column D. I want to go equals. As I'm linking, I'm going to click on the sheet that I want and click on the cell. As I want to add the two together, plus, click on finished goods 2, click on the cell and press enter. Then check it, 22 plus 10 equals 32, so I know the formula is correct, so I can double click to flash fill. In column G, I need to use an if statement. So I need a formula, fx and if. It's saying to select the correct inventory under IAS2 for the valuation of closing inventory. So we've got cost and net realizable. So I'm going to say if cost is less than net realizable, then display net realizable. Otherwise, display cost. If I see 199, then I know I've done the formula right. Then I can flash fill. And they will basically replicate the formula down. It's saying in column G, use conditional formatting to highlight the value at net realizable in red and cost in green. So I want to do conditional formatting home and go to highlight and equal to. I want cost, and I'm going to take out the dollar sign between E and 3 because I only want to lock the column E. If cost is lowest, then I want it to be in green. Otherwise, equal to. If net realizable is lowest, I'm going to take the dollar sign out, I want it in red. And there we have that. It says, in column H, use a formula to calculate the total inventory on the 31st of March. So the total inventory, I'm doing a formula, so it'll be equals, open bracket, the total number required multiplied the lowest value, close bracket, and enter. Check it on your calculator if you're happy, then flash fill. It's saying, make sure this column is showing everything in full, so I just double-clicked on the line between H and I. And then it's saying format the numbers in H to two decimal places, pound sign. So I'm going to right click, format cells, currency, two decimal places and pound sign. In row 2, wrap headings so they are clearly visible. So row 2's here. I want to wrap the heading, so I'm going to click on alignment, wrap text, and you'll see they've come onto two lines. Part B, complete the following in the summary worksheet. Use a subtotal to calculate the total inventory range value. So I'm going to go to data, outline, subtotal. As I want it in range, I will leave that as range. It's saying to total, so it'll be sum, and I want to do it for total inventory value, so I'll click OK. And there we have the total inventory value. You have got the answers here, so you can actually check to see if it's been done correctly or not. So 36712, 36712, and then I've got the dreamy, which means I'm on the right line. It's now saying hide columns B to G. So I'm going to highlight B all the way across to G, right click and hide. Ensure the titles and ranges can be seen, which you can. It says copy the summary worksheet onto a new worksheet. So I'm going to go magic triangle or control A. Control copy or home and copy. Click on a plus for a new worksheet, control V or drop down and paste all. It's now saying rename it to inventory 31st March 2006. So I could double click or right click rename. I'm going to be calling this inventory 31st March 2006. Insert 3D onto the chart, excluding grand total. So I'm going to highlight my data. I'm going to go to home. Now, the reason why I've closed all the data, if I do it this way, it's going to be too much information and it would distort the chart. So I only want the totals. So I've got all my totals for Dreamy, New City, etc. Highlight that. I'm going to go to pie chart and I want a 3D pie chart. But I don't want to include grand total. As you can see, I've not selected grand total. It says amend the title, total year end inventory value. So I'm just going to double click in the title and I'm going to type in what it's asked me to type. Click off when you're done. It's now saying that I need to add data labels. So in the add element chart, I'm going to go data labels, more labels. It's saying to two decimal places. So I want the value and it's giving me to two decimal places. So that's fine. And it says change the color of any segments where the data labels are not clearly seen. I can see all of mine, but this one I'm just going to change because it's a bit dark. So I'm just going to go to fill, make it big, and I'm going to choose a lighter color. Saying in the chart, explode the segment for the range with the largest inventory value. The largest inventory value is this one here. So I'm clicking on the chart, you'll see the circles all the way around it. Clicking on it again, so it's only on that segment. Left click, hold and pull out, and you can see that I've exploded the chart with the largest value. It says resize so all the data can be seen clearly. So if I'm going to do that, I'm going to go to the corner, drag, left click, hold, drag out, and move the chart wherever I want it to be. And then it's saying, save your chart. So I'm just going to save my work, and there we have it, Chapter 2, Scenario 2 complete.